Warrior workout, and I think we're going to try to get it done in about 20 minutes. We might be a little bit over, but it's a really good workout with a focus on your legs, your glutes, your core. Just before we begin, I wanted to quickly tell you about the connection to your pelvis to effectively work through your core, including this entire area. So a lot of times today, you're going to hear me refer to having your tailbone back and behind you. You don't want to overdo the tailbone. You want to have it sunk down between your heels with your breastbone lifted up and forward. So when you're squatting, just be aware that you're not starting to tip down that way. That's not effective and it's really not that safe. It's a great workout, so we're going to jump right in. And in a perfect world, you would do this workout 3 times a week. And you would also add to that some cardio, hiking, jogging, power walking, your choice, for 20 to 30 moderate to intense minutes, and a clean and healthy diet. We have a challenge coming up for 6 weeks leading up to the holidays, and it's called the Little Black Dress Challenge for our local and our virtual clients. So I really hope that you'll check it out. We'll put the link here on the video so you can have a look. Okay, so we've done a warm-up. We're assuming that you've done a couple of minutes warm-up. Just get the blood flowing, whether that's a quick spin, jogging on the spot, a little bit of skipping. Just take a second, stretch out through your shoulders and also through your low back, especially if it's first thing in the morning and you've just kind of hopped out of bed and you've been sleeping all night. Or hopefully you've been sleeping all night, most of the night. The first thing we're going to do is a set of deadlifts. So I'm just going to ask you to grab some lighter weights if you have a couple pairs. If you only have one set of dumbbells at home, that's okay. Maybe just grab one dumbbell to start with. When you do a deadlift, you want to keep your chest and your rib cage pressed forward. As soon as you let it fall, you start to become a little more susceptible in your spine. So take a deep breath. Push the chest and the ribs forward, shoulders back and down. Feet are fairly close together, if not touching. You're going to angle your hips back towards the wall behind you. Push your heels into the floor and squeeze the pelvis forward. Take a deep breath in and pull up. You're not pulling with your arms. You're pulling from where you feel the stretch in your hamstrings. Try to focus on tipping the hips back, pressing back through your hips and your heels rather than bending forward. This isn't a forward bend in your spine. It's actually a nice straight spine. It's a tip back in the hips, weight back on the heels, lift your toes. Let's go for 6 more. Nice deep breaths. Pick up the pace. 6. Squeeze at the top. Deep breath in. 5. 4 more. Chest out. Squeeze up. Last 3. Squeeze at the top, 2 more. Last one. Good. So we just got the blood moving, started to connect to our breath, which is hugely important in your workouts. That's where a lot of your energy comes from, oxygen. So always remember to breathe deeply. Exhale on your exertion if you're ever wondering where you're inhaling and exhaling. Next exercise, football lunges. So I'm going to ask you to take a really wide low lunge. Your feet are hip bone width apart, shoulder width apart. You're not on a tightrope. From here, you're going to hinge down. Now, for some people, depending on your flexibility, that might be fingertips at your ankles. For other people, that might actually be fingertips to the floor. But wherever you can be and still keep a nice straight spine, pull back so the weight is on your front heel, not over your toes. And from here, you're going to pull up with just your front leg. So chest up, look up, pull up. Don't push off from the back leg. Resist that. Take a deep breath in. Find your position. Pull back on the heel and pull up and squeeze under. There's that pelvis powering up. Weight on the heel. Push the heel through the floor and squeeze the glutes up and under. There's 3, 4. No arms, no back leg. Power up from the front leg. 5. Let's go 5 more. All the way up, squeeze. 4, up and squeeze, good. Last 3, chest up, look up. 2 more,
Power up from the front heel. Squeeze under. Good. Last one. Power up, power up, power up. Awesome. Other side, other leg. Really important to get your form. So stop the video if you need and practice a couple of times. Take a wide, deep step. Come into a lunge. Chest up. Make sure your feet are wide enough apart to have good balance. Your weight's on your front heel. Fingertips to the floor or the outside of your ankles. Pull just from the front leg. Don't use the back leg. Don't use your arms. Power up from the front. There's three. Deep breath in. Find your position. Four. Good. Five. Deep breath in. Six. Seven. Next deep breath. Pull back. Eight. Chest up. Chest up. Straight spine. Nine. One more. 10. Whew, okay, that should get your heart rate going. Okay, I'm going to go on to some slow squats. I'm going to turn sideways so that you can just take notice of where and how I'm working my pelvis by focusing on my tailbone. You're going to place your lighter dumbbells on the top of your shoulders. If you think about tipping them up at the front end, you'll keep your breastbone up, your core stretched apart through your rib cage. Slowly, you're going to go down for three counts. Keep your shoulder blades squeezed together. Go down for three, two, one. Keep your chest up. Now pull back. Weight on the heels. Squeeze your quads for three, two, one. And push up for three, two, one. Push your heels to the floor. Don't lock your knees. Keep in the muscle. Little faster. Three, two, one. One, pull back, way back for three, two, one, push up and squeeze, two, one, back down, two, one, pull back, two, one, push up, two, one, inhale down, pull back, exhale up and stay in the muscle, squeeze, deep breath in, two, one, pull back, two, one, push up, two, one, down, two, one, pull back, two, one, push up, two, one, and squeeze, down, two, one, pull back, two, one, push up, two, one, two more, down, two, one, pull back, squeeze, and up, one more, down, back, and heels to the floor. Awesome. Our last one in this sequence is going to be one more set of deadlifts. Now that you've got your form, I'm going to ask you to go a little heavier, which is either going to be both your dumbbells, or if you have the option, grab a heavier set of dumbbells. Okay. Heels together or close together, chest up, shoulders back and down. Push your ribs forward. There's a strong spine and an engaged core. Here's a weak spine and an unengaged core. So there's disengaged core. There's the difference. Chest up, nice deep breath in. Push your heels to the floor, angle back and squeeze the pelvis forward. Find a stretch through your hamstrings, shoulders back, and squeeze up. There's two. Deep breath, deep breath, deep breath. There's three. Deep breath in, chest out. Four. Abs are strong, glutes are tight. Big pull. Five. Find a stretch. Six. Lengthen back. Stretch your hamstrings and pull from there. Seven. Eight. Nine. One more. Ten. Awesome. So one thing my clients learn, one of my training principles for highly effective training, what we call high performance training, is that a stretch leads to your next best contraction. If you haven't learned that yet, make sure that you do. A stretch helps you to understand which muscles you're working in an exercise. So when you come into a movement, you'll feel a stretch through your hamstrings. That's where your mind goes
to pull up and then contract through that same region. Your body helps you to know where you're working. It's great. Okay, we're going to pick up the pace just a bit. So grab some water. Keep your towel handy. Hopefully you'll need it. The next section is crouch step-ups. Ten a leg with an upper body exercise in between. There's over 100 reps in this sequence. So we're going to slowly keep picking up the pace, okay? A crouch step up, you take a good step back, not too far. Lean forward slightly. Your upper body is bringing your chest close to the knee. Weight on the front heel and pulling up from there. So not quite as far back as a football lunge. A crouch step up. All your weight is through that front leg. Go three. Arms outstretched, ribs outstretched, and pull the pelvis forward. Five, come down, pull back, pull up. Six, come down, pull back, pull up. Seven, eight, nine, active arms, and 10. Other leg already. So everything we've done so far this morning is building up to now have you ready for this one. We're going to focus on coming down, pulling back on the heel, just like the squats. Lengthen, just like the squats. Pull from the front leg, just like your football lunges. There's four. Active arms. Five. Last five. Four. Shoulders back and down. Three. Two. Last one. So when I say shoulders back and down, I don't mean your shoulders here. I actually mean through your shoulder girdle. Back and down, chest up, shoulder girdle. Don't be lifting like this. You can still lift your arms and have your shoulder girdle with your shoulder blades pinched together in the back. Shoulder press now, same thing. Chest up, shoulder blades, shoulders back and down. Legs engaged. Tuck your hip bones slightly forward, tailbone under. Don't lock your knees. Take a nice deep breath in. Exhale, right above the shoulders. Inhale, find a stretch. Press straight up. So what you're not doing is clanking in. You're staying above your shoulders the whole way up. When you come down, don't just drop your arms. Stay in the muscle. Find a stretch. Come down to about here, chest up. And again, five more. And again, four, legs tight, abs tight, glutes tight, three, two, last one, and carefully down. Take a tiny breather, feet maybe a little wider, let's go again. 10 reps, ready? Chest up, legs engaged, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Whew. So to keep our intensity up, we're going back to our crouch step ups, 10 a leg. Get ready for it. Take a nice deep breath in. Come down, pull out. One, two, three, four, chest up, five, weight on the front heel, pull down, six, pull the pelvis forward, seven, eight, nine, 10. Other side, other leg, ready, and here we go. Power up, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Next in, side laterals. You may need to move down to lighter weights than you were using for your shoulder press. Side laterals is a bit of a larger movement with a smaller part of your shoulder, smaller muscle group. So chest up, little bend in your arms. You're going to think about pulling apart
and lifting with your elbows to the side of your shoulders. Apart and up. Apart and up. Think of starting at 6 on a clock. Pull up to 9 and 3. Back down. Pull apart and up. Slow it down at the top. Squeeze up. Keep the chest up. Go for 5. Last 4. 3 more. Last 2. Last 1. A lot of times, we'll do one more step. A lot of times I get asked on how the angle in the arm should be. If you have really heavy dumbbells, you're gonna keep a tighter angle. You're gonna keep more of a right angle. They're a little heavy for you. You're gonna pretend that you don't have any hands and you're just gonna lift from your elbows. If you have a set of dumbbells that is extremely light for you, you can pretty much take them right out to the side, but don't lock your elbows. Stay in the muscle. Right out to the side. Slight bend in the arms, out to the side. So that's how you know. You feel it out with your body. One more set of 10. Ready? Legs are engaged, tailbone tucked forward to protect your back. Up and out. 1. Up and out. 2. Up and out. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7, keep strong. 8, 9, one more. 10. Okay, oh my goodness. We're back to crouch step ups. Find your position, get ready for it. 10 a leg, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10. Other side. Ready? And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10. Woo! Okay, on to bicep curls. Hopefully, you're starting to get nice and warm, keeping the intensity up. Again, you want to tighten through your glutes, roll your tailbone under to protect your back and work through your lower abs. Shoulder blades are squeezed together. You're going to curl right up to the front of your shoulder. Pretend that you're going to jump in the side of a swimming pool. So you want to lean forward a bit. And you're carrying one bar straight up in front. One bar with your shoulder blades squeezed together. Going to go for 5. Stay connected on the way down. 4. 3. Last 2. One more. Awesome. I want to give you a tip about building up the intensity in your workout. A lot of people talk about it, but not very many people teach you how. So when you're training, the first thing you learn is your movement. You're going to do a curl and you're going to go up and down. The second thing you learn is your form. Hopefully, if you're working with a coach, a trainer, or a good workout partner, you've learned that you're going to lean forward a little bit with a bicep curl so that you're not working with gravity. You're gonna squeeze your shoulder blades together to ensure that they're not doing the work through your shoulders, that your biceps are doing the work. You're gonna tuck your pelvis forward to power up from your core, and you're going to curl right into the front of your shoulder. That's form. If you haven't learned that, I'm sorry, but you're learning it now, so practice it. Intensity comes by really connecting your mind to your muscle, finding your peak contraction and not losing that contraction throughout your set. So with my clients, we get going and then I get them to start pretending that they've got a roll of toilet paper right in their elbow joint. So as they bring it up, they got to squeeze past that roll of toilet paper, which has a bit of give, but not a whole lot. Stay connected on the way down. Come all the way up. Slow it down. Squeeze hard. Squeeze hard. Squeeze hard. Not all the way up. Just about to the top, but not all the way. Squeeze hard. Squeeze hard. Squeeze hard. Keep the shoulder blades together. Go for five. Tight, tight, tight. Last four. Right up, right up, right up, right up. Three. Deep breath, deep breath, deep breath. Two more. Last one. Tight, 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 tight. And down. Awesome.
Last set of crouch step-ups. Find your position. Ready? And 10. 9. 8. 7. 6. Pelvis forward. 5. 4. 3. 2. Last one. Make sure when you're picking up your pace, you're still staying behind your front heel. Don't be over your knee. Stay back. Focus on the pelvis and the glutes. Here we go. Ready? Pull back. Push from the heel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Woo! Okay. Your last upper body movement of this sequence, and you're doing well, is overhead triceps. Gonna turn this way so again, you can see my focus through my shoulder girdle. Hip bones rolled forward to protect your back. Shoulders back and down through your shoulder girdle. You wanna bring your dumbbell down to 90 or just past, and then work at stretching your triceps back by your ears before you press straight up above the crown of your head. So it doesn't matter how low you drop your dumbbell, bring it down to 90 or just a little more. Focus on stretching back through the tricep and then up for the same reason. You want to connect to the tricep. So find the stretch and contract from there. Find the stretch and contract from there. Tight, tight, tight. All the way up. Don't lock out. Stay connected. Stay connected. Right up. Back down. Four more. Last three. Two more. Last one. Awesome. Another effective or high performance training principle that my clients are learning is the value of opposing directions, opposing contractions when you're training. So if some of your muscles are pulling and other muscles are pushing, you're really going to be able to isolate where you're working. It's not a beginner principle. It takes some work and some time, but in this exercise, see if you can just observe. You're going to be pulling down with your shoulder girdle, pull down as tight as you can through your shoulder blades, at the same time that you're extending up through your tricep. So you're pulling down, yet you're extending up. Pulling down, extending up. Abs are tight, glutes are tight. Down and up. Pull down through the shoulder blades. Keep pulling down through the shoulder blades. Pulling down through the shoulder blades. Extending up. All the way up. Tight, tight, tight. For four. Three. Two. Last one. Woo! That is how to take your training to the next level. All right, that's the end of our crouch step-up sequence. That was over 100 reps. Super proud of you for making it through that. We're gonna take it now down onto the mat, and I'm just gonna ask you if you could grab some water, just grab your towel for a second. I'm just gonna line up my mat a little differently to hopefully be quite visible on camera. And keep your lighter set of dumbbells close to you for this sequence. Okay, we have some downward dog push-ups with some glute extensions. We also have a couple of ab exercises, and then we're going to finish off with a stretch. So the first thing I want you to do is just take a nice deep breath. Make sure your heart rate is down before you put your head lower than your legs and your butt. Let's come into a downward dog. So your pinkies line up with the outside edges of your mat. You're going to step back and lengthen through your torso to the point where you can almost get your heels down on the mat, right down from your hips, lined up with your hips, heels in line with your toes, not out, not in. Suction cup your hands and push back and away from you to stretch back through your tailbone, through your hips, your hamstrings, your calves, even down towards your Achilles. And you're just going to walk it out for a few, all the way down. Such a nice stretch after all of those crouch step ups. I'm going to demonstrate what a downward dog push up is, and then we're going to take it to your knee. Okay, so a full one, and it's challenging, is instead of having your weight back over your hips, you're going to start to bring it forward over your shoulders. Your hands don't really change position. We're going to keep your torso long, elbows wrap in, and we're going to tap your nose towards your mat. Keep the chest out, come down halfway if you're unsure, and then press up. A full one is all the way down, shoulders back, but you need strong arms and shoulders. Here's your other option. Place your knee back, keep your torso long, keep your leg up and tight, foot is flexed. We're going to take it down and up. Similar to our tea kettle push-up, down and up. Deep breath in, down and up, elbows in, chest out, long through the torso, abs in, down and up. Again, you can do this anywhere. A set of dumbbells and a mat, you can do it anywhere. Let's go for five. Four more. Stay long, bring your hips with you. Three, last two. One more. All right, now we're gonna change it into a glute extension. You've just finished contracting isometrically through that glute and hamstring through your whole stretch. So we're gonna actually take it into a glute extension from there. All the way up, full extension and back. All the way up, press from your heel, full extension, nice and strong. Let's go for eight. Back down, seven, six, good, last five, four more, last three, two, one more, press from your heel, squeeze through the leg and glute. Okay, we're gonna take it to the other side. We're almost done. We just have abs after this. I'm gonna get you to flip your yoga mat up in case you need more cushion for your knee. So again, to find your right position, come into a downward dog, fingertips on the edge of your mat, press it back, stay long, start to bring your weight above your hands and your shoulders, keep your torso long, take one knee down but lengthen through your ribs, one leg up, abs are strong, glutes are tight, nice long lines in the body, we're going to take the nose down. It's about 3 inches. In front of your fingertips, elbows in, and press back. Deep breath in, and press back. Deep breath in, and press back. Nice and strong. Let's go for six. All the way up, last five, and up. Four more, and up. Last three, right up. Two more, last one. Same thing, glute lifts. Keep that leg strong, curled, foot flexed. We're gonna sit all the way up, full extension. All the way up, squeeze up through the glute and the hamstring. All the way up and squeeze. Great way to finish off our workout. Great complement to our deadlifts and our crouch step ups. Let's go for six. Last five, four more. Last three, two, last one. Awesome job, you guys. We've got two more exercises to go. Come down on your backs and take your lighter set of dumbbells in your hand. Whew, lighter set. Hopefully you can still see what I'm doing here. I'm gonna ask you to take your elbows and tuck them in tight by your sides. Your dumbbells are just resting on your torso, but you're still got engaged arms. You're gonna pull your shoulders back, pull your lower back down, and we're gonna do a set of heel slides. Depending on the strength of your back, you're gonna keep the lower back down the whole time, lengthen your legs, touch your heels down, and slide them back in. If you've got really strong abs, you can take them quite long and slowly slide them back in. If you're just learning, you might take one, pull it in, and then the other, pull it in. Somewhere in between would be a slow circle. Keep the lower back down, keep the lower back down, keep the lower back down the whole time. A nice slow circle. Lower back down, and a slow circle back in. Press the lower back down, and a slow circle. Go for five. Last four. Three. Two. Last one. Awesome. Carefully put your dumbbells down. Be really careful that you're not just going to torque them out from your shoulder by flipping it over. You want to just be careful of that. You want to carefully put them down. Your last ab exercise is actually called a butterfly. And you want to stay nice and open through your shoulders and nice and open through your legs. Open them up slightly. So a butterfly is just heels down, toes up, keeping everything, all four corners nice and open. We're going to come together and squeeze like big wings on a butterfly. Back down, lower back down, up and together, toes are flexed. You don't need to come all the way down to the floor. Just find your contraction by pulling your lower back down. And now flexion by squeezing together. Rib cage to hip bones, lower back down. Exhale and squeeze together, lower back down. I'm inhaling, drawing my belly button to the mat. Exhaling and squeezing together for five more. Tight, tight, tight. Last four. Tight, tight, tight. Three more. Last two. Tight, tight, tight. One more. Awesome. So again, depending on your time, how much time you have for your workout today, you could complete one more round of your downward dog push-ups, one more round of your crunches, both the butterfly crunches and your heel slides. And you can also do a couple of planks in there. But if you're rushing, finish off with a couple of good stretches, especially for your hips, your quads, your hamstrings. But we're just over 30 minutes now, and we're gonna wrap it up for today. I hope you enjoy your October Warrior Workout. I look forward to your comments and invite you to check out powHERhouse.com for more ways, strategies, solutions, tips, tools, and ideas about how you can stay strong in your body, your business, and your life. Thanks.